If you need to collect data across multiple websites, you can use cross-domain measurement to attribute activity to a single customer. For example, you may have one website where customers shop and a separate website for processing transactions. In cases like these, you would want to set up cross-domain measurement so you can report on the user journey across both websites. To use cross-domain measurement, you'll want to collect all website data in the same property, meaning each website will use the same measurement ID and be collected together in a single data stream. You'll also need to have editor permission on the property. Let's walk through the process. First, open the admin menu and click Data Streams. You should see your existing data streams. In this case, we only have one web stream. Click on it to open its settings. Click Configure Tag Settings. Then choose Configure Your Domains. Enter the information for the domains that you want to include. In our earlier example, where you have two websites, you could create a condition contains website one domain and a second condition for contains website two domain. You can test to make sure this works by starting on website one and navigating from that website to the second website, like going from the shopping cart to a payments page. If cross-domain measurement has been implemented correctly, you should see the linker parameter in the URL when you land on the website two. This parameter starts with underscore GL and then a string of characters. Google Analytics automatically recognizes what website a customer visited immediately before arriving on your site. It will display the domain names of those sites as referral traffic sources in your reports. You can make sure that your reports only include relevant referrals by creating a set of filtering conditions to filter out traffic. You'll want to identify and filter out these unwanted referrals to your website. Unwanted referrals are segments of website traffic that arrive on your website through unintended sources, like links from third-party websites. For example, an unwanted referral could be a third-party payment processor for purchases on your site that redirects a customer to their domain, processes the payment, and then redirects back to your website. Without setting the domain of the payment processor as an unwanted referral, the payment processor would show up as a referral source in your acquisition data. To filter out domain traffic, go into the admin menu and open up the data stream settings. Click on the web stream you want to filter, and then choose Configure Tag Settings. If some settings are hidden, choose Show All and find List Unwanted Referrals. Here, you can add any domains that you want to exclude from the referral data. In this example, we want to add the domain of the payment processor website and then save. Once you've set up a filter, Google Analytics will exclude this domain from referral reports like the traffic source report. Filter conditions are evaluated for every web page on which you have a Google Analytics tag. By default, Analytics will not identify traffic as a referral from your domain or other domains that you own that are set up as part of cross-domain measurement. Keep in mind, you can only configure a maximum of 50 unwanted referrals per data stream. Finally, you can also set up a data filter. A data filter lets you filter out data so that it isn't processed by Google Analytics and won't show up in your reports. There are two main reasons to use these filters. The first is to exclude internal traffic coming from you or your employees. The second is to use a data filter to exclude developer traffic when developers are using tools to debug or troubleshoot issues. When this filter is active, Google Analytics will filter out any data collected from users when debug mode is enabled. This will allow you or your developer to test in your property without disrupting the data in your reports. You can set up either of these filters in the admin menu under Data Filters. From here, you can choose Create Filter and are given the option to exclude either developer or internal traffic. To set up a filter for developer traffic, choose developer traffic and then name the filter. Then set the filter state to either testing or active. If the filter state is testing, then the data will still appear in reporting, but it can be identified using the test data filter name dimension. If the filter state is active, then the data will be filtered out and excluded from processing and reporting. Click the Create button to save the new filter. Setting up an internal traffic filter follows these same steps and has the same options for the filter state. However, there's one extra step before creating an internal traffic filter. You must first define your internal traffic using an IP address or a range of IP addresses. Go back to the admin menu and go into the data stream settings. Choose your data stream and then choose configure tag settings. Once again, if settings are hidden, choose show all and find define internal traffic. Create the rule for internal traffic by entering an IP address or a range of IP addresses. If you have multiple ranges, you can add another condition to add another range. Once you've entered your internal IP address, choose create. Now that you've defined your internal traffic, you can head back over to the admin menu and then back into data filters. As before, create a new filter, and this time choose internal traffic. Name the filter, choose the filter state, and choose create to save the filter. Remember, Google Analytics evaluates data filters from the point of creation going forward. Data filters do not affect historical data, and once you apply a data filter, you will not be able to recover any data that has been filtered out. So be thoughtful when you set these up.